Good morning, Hutchison Hawks. I'm Ariel Traxler, and as you know, this is your Hawk Hit News. Yet another day of the Hawk Hit News for your viewing pleasure. We have lots of interesting news stories coming at you, so stay tuned for your Hawk Hit headlines. A missing cat was found living in a couch that an unknown Utah woman dropped off at a local thrift store. A woman shared photos of the stowaway cat with the couch to the Facebook group Carbon and Emery Yard Sale, and wrote that someone had left the animal and the couch at a nearby deserted industries thrift shop. NFL player Sam Barrington decided to do some fishing during the offseason and wound up catching a massive shark. Barrington, a linebacker for the Green Bay Packers, shared a photo of himself with a 400-pound bull shark, which he caught while filming an episode of the fishing show Black Tip H. A Florida pet owner shared a video of his Pomeranian dog loudly asserting his dominance over a western rat snake found in the family's garden. A video shows Cosmo the Pomeranian voicing his loud displeasure with the western rat snake Skinner is holding in his home's backyard. The footage shows Cosmo barking at the snake while Skinner holds the serpent and sets it down on the ground to show how the dog can fight his own battles. The snake appears to try to bite Cosmo, but the dog is too fast and remains unscathed. There you go for your Hawk Hit headlines. Let's kick it over to Samuel Heaton with your news you need to know.
Hi guys. I'm Sam Heaton and you're watching the news you need to know. First, I just got finished tying my shoe here. Every Thursday after school, there's a GSA meeting right here in Miss Cornell's room. Hi guys, I'm here with Miss Rainio, and she's going to tell us a little bit about April being School Library and Poetry Month.
So April is School Library Month and also Poetry Month, and to celebrate that, this month we are having a Maker Fair event every Thursday after school from 3 to 4. So this week we are having crochet and knitting, so you can learn to make basic crochet patterns. And next week we're having someone from Tanana Middle School come to do a coding camp, and they're going to use a Sphero robot and teach people how to code to make that robot run around the library through a maze. It'll be pretty fun. So hope you guys can join us.
The prom is going to be on April 23rd, this Saturday, from 7 to 11 p.m. at the J.P. Jones Center. The theme for this year is Rustic Romance. Right now, tickets are on sale during lunch, $30 for a single and $50 for a couple. Right now, tickets are open to all grades, and you can also vote for a prom king and queen. From April 25th to May 6th, the freshmen are going to be holding the annual book drive. All donated books are going to be given to the Literacy Council. The class that brings the most books will get ice cream sandwiches. All right, that's it for the news you need to know. This is Sam Heaton. Back to you guys in the studio. Is that good?
Thanks, Samuel. We all know you have some questions about this year's yearbook, so let's put our hands together for our very own Mr. Johnson and Emma Daniels.
Hey.
Hello.
Glad to be on set.
So, Emma, as a yearbook editor, I would like to know about this year's yearbook. Tell me about the new design.
The new design is looking at the school and just like our lives from a different angle or a different perspective. So on the front, we kind of did an oil paint design, almost like a simple modern cover. But on the inside, we have a lot of focus on content and coverage and looking at things behind the scenes and seeing what's really going on in your clubs and, you know, your different sports teams, and what kind of things did you joke about and have fun with, and things that were memorable versus just what your team did. On the back, we have this great quote, which says, "It is a narrow mind which cannot look at a subject from a various point of view," which I think is really fitting to this year's different themes that we have and different interesting pages we have going on. We have the augmented reality feature, just like last year, where you can take your phone and download this app called Erasma, and then hover it over the pages, and you'll get a cool video or a graphic popping up.
Wow.
And we also have a really nice senior superlative page this year, and baby photos.
So. Superlatives, ooh. Yes. Can you give us a sneak peek of what those superlatives might be?
I can. So I know that we have Drama King and Queen, which was Noah Richards and Saskia Harrison, which I think was just because they both have, you know, really funny personalities and they're always cracking jokes.
Sounds fitting.
The other one we have is Most Alaskan, which was Noah Khalsa and Gabe Reuter. I know Gabe skis, and I think Noah K just like fits into that with his personality. And then we have Best Style, which was Vanessa Jimerson and Taylor Tomaszewski.
Oh, she looks good every day.
Yeah, and they both have a really unique style. It's really pretty.
So that's just a preview of them. Everybody got one, and Emma didn't want to mention hers on there, but I'm going to call her out on it. She got most sass.
Me and Morgan Husky got most sass. And I think that's really funny, and we both thought it was great.
So, Mr. Johnson, you've decided to make this year's book a fall delivery. Mm-hmm. Can you explain why and what the benefits are in this decision?
We're always trying to do like the best thing for the school and the student body and what they want. So we've moved our deadline around. We went with fall this year because as we look at past year's yearbooks and the way that our school year falls and how the printing companies want it, we had to leave out a lot when we were giving the book now. You know, West Valley Lathrop, they'll give their books out now, but they're not going to have baseball and softball. They certainly won't have their graduation. And we just kind of collectively got together, and you kind of saw the list there on the screen. Maybe they can pop that back up, because it's a long list of things that get included if we deliver that book in the fall. You know, things like Hutch Idol or the end of year talent show. It's awesome to be able to open your book in the fall and bam, your whole year was there. So we wanted to kind of come back to that. It's a little bit different for Alaska, but it's actually something that's really common in the lower 48 to have fall delivery.
I know
books.
Those people graduating are going to want to see themselves in their yearbook.
That's certainly what we thought, and it really benefits the seniors a ton because there's so much packed into this last, you know, 5 weeks, as you guys know.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, to conclude our interview here, I have one more question for Emma. Can you explain how people can purchase their yearbooks this year?
You can purchase your yearbook on treering.com, or you can also just go to the Hutchison High School website, and it should be at the top of the page. There is a code that you have to put in. I don't see it on that graphic, but you can find it out in the commons right now on a big banner. So go take a picture of it and bring it home. You can pay with credit card. It's really easy. Or a gift. You could probably even use like a Visa gift card if you do have cash and can go put some cash on there. It's quick, it's easy, and then there are different surprises you can find on that page too.
And we did set it up that you can, if you can't figure out how to do it online or that freaks you out totally, we do have it, the ability now for you to come to the lunch table and you can buy there.
Oh, that's great. I hate online purchases.
The key is it's all got to be done by April 30th. April 30th, that's when it shuts down. That's why I want to get this interview in right now.
Okay.
So make sure you buy your book, because April 30th, you can't buy your book anymore, and we won't be selling extras.
Well, that's all some great stuff, guys. I haven't ordered my yearbook yet, so I'll definitely need to get on that. Well, I hope that answers all your questions you had about this year's yearbook. Be sure to purchase your yearbook ASAP. That's all we have for time for your Hawk Hit News. I'm Ariel Traxler, signing off. Stay fly, Hawks.